Hey, it's Steve Zellinardo here with REMAX West Zellinardo Associates. Just a real quick update on the market. 13,133 units. Yeah, it's a little cold here in Florida. I think it's 80 this afternoon, but it's cool. So I have already thin blood. So we're at 13,133 units and 638 units actually sold in last week. So again, redundant material that we're presenting here. No real change. A few things to look out for is, and I'll just shrink the screen here and kind of take a look. Inflation. So inflation was reported November 16th, and it's basically exact same number as it was in September. So this is going to cause an issue. Why? Because we still have another interest rate announcement December 7th. So this could further increase the interest rates. And we know mortgages right now, we're at 5.8% for a five-year fix. Obviously, if you're dealing with a mortgage broker, they can potentially buy it down a little further, but that's where we're currently are right now. Things to look out for, and this was not a surprise to me because I kind of mentioned this prior to, anyway, sometime this year I was talking about how we're just going to keep getting taxed and the erosion of capitalism, and just someone's going to have to pay for all the debt that was occurred the last couple years with the government overspending and overdoing it naturally. And this is one method of how they're going to get the money. I just want to start with this. This is awesome. So this is all this data was collected. Okay, by research, this data was collected by a research company for Generation Squeeze. So they've named this specifically Generation Squeeze. So just keep that in mind, Generation Squeeze, okay? But anyway, so what they're talking about now is they want to tax houses over $1 million. It's going to be a luxury tax, similar to what Europe would have, similar to other parts of the world would have, but it's a luxury tax. If you have a home over $1 million, you're going to pay another surtax. So that it says here 50% of the people would be in favor of this. So I don't know where they're getting these numbers from, 57%. I'm sure as we are Canadians now suffering with currently what's happening in the world, events, inflation, cost of living, we have no more money to give. So I don't know how there's 57% of these people that have voted yes, this is a good idea. We should tax more people on possessions that we have. So, you know, look at this. They're talking about, there's a piece of this article where they're saying that, I forgot what they, okay, so they're talking about how many houses are worth over $1 million. So it says, and so again, this is broad Canada. Survey released on Monday found 62% of residents would support a modest surtax. What is modest? And when it starts modest, there's always a chance for that to go even higher. So there's no modest. It's just a break-in in period, and then they're going to just keep jacking until you got nothing left. On homes valued above $1 million, which make 10% of Canada's housing market. So we're in Ontario. We know that $1 million house doesn't buy you much in today's market. So how can they say it's 10% of Canada's housing market? This is probably 95% of our market. And I'll tell you, and I'll show you our statistics, and you know, these articles frustrate me because they're kind of painting everything with one paintbrush, like all of Canada. I think, let's say in Ontario, maybe it should be $2 million if they are going to proceed with this. You can't just paint one brush across $1 million surtax. I'll show you our statistics on, sorry, I have a lot of stuff I'm looking at this morning. Where is it? Okay, so look at this. This is the province of Ontario, and not even Ontario. This is the GTA and some outer skirts. So York Region, Toronto, Simcoe, Peel, Halton, Durham, and Dufferin. Basically, our daily drive. Okay, look at this. These are real figures. Okay, a detached home average sales price in today's market. This is as relevant as from January 2021 to October 22. So this is, we got an average sales price for a detached at $1.5 million. Semi-detached, $1.2 million. A condo townhouse falls below this, fair enough, at $880,000. Condo apartment, $760,000. A link-style house is over $1 million, and a townhouse is $1.1 million. And a detached, I don't know what that is, detached condo. I don't know, that's a new product. I've never seen that. But anyway, going back to this is that, remind you, these are probably like little single-family homes in a like sort of like not a gated community, but have expenditures like street maintenance and garbage pickup. So anyway, everything's over $1 million. If you kind of look at just those four products, that's basically 95% of our, or maybe let's say 90% of our current market. Obviously, condos makes a big percentage, but let's just talk about low-rise. It's about 90-95% is over $1 million. So that means everyone in Ontario is going to be taxed this luxury tax, which is a little frustrating because they're starting, you know, they keep trying to pick at us and pick at our savings and pick at what we own until we got nothing left. And this is what's currently happening now. How many people are going to want to buy a house over $1 million if they have to pay a surtax? As they're shrinking that number down, where you're going to be, it's going to have one of two effects. Number one, you're not going to be able to afford it, so you're going to look elsewhere. Maybe they're trying to get people to move out into Calgary, Alberta, kind of distribute to Saskatchewan more people, because this is obviously you don't pay a surtax there because their houses are a lot less value. And number two, it's going to be, if we don't have the buyers for these properties, what's going to do is going to bring down the value in order to get these buyers to afford it. So if you have a $1.2 million townhouse now that's going to have an applied surtax, people might not just buy it. They might just sit tight, move to another province, move country, or they'll wait to this get to a certain amount under the 1 million mark and then ultimately go from there. And this is probably a good indication that the fraud will start happening, where they'll start changing money underneath the table. There's going to be something about this where they might just claim so much of the house sold and go from there. I would imagine the province and the federal government's going to have some sort of some appraisal program going forward that'll obviously get the proper appraisal of the houses where fraud can't be committed. But I would imagine in the beginning it'll start with some sort of fraud to kind of fly underneath the radar. And that's like, we had friends from Greece, and that's exactly what they would do. They would understate everything. Everything was in cash. They would put things in other people's names. It was always this trickle, just try to beat the system. But that's pretty much it, guys. If you have any questions regarding real estate, you can always reach out to me at 647-962-4372, and we'll get you on the next video. Ciao.